Okay, so anyways, the Metro Police had gotten a call that someone had hit and run. Got in a car, hit another car, and ran.
Drove off.
Didn't drive off, ran off.
Ran off.
This was at 9 a.m., 8:47 a.m. in the morning.
You look so puzzled. Like, I understand why you're puzzled. People who commit crimes often do stupid things. They're usually not the smartest people.
Right, but even at the time of the day, it doesn't really matter for Las Vegas. It's 8 a.m. in the morning, 8:40 a.m. It doesn't matter.
So let me get this straight. Two cars hit each other, and he took off out of the car running.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
And the Las Vegas police actually found the guy and put him in handcuffs for questioning. Because they weren't 1,000% certain this was the guy. But during the interview with him, he slipped out of handcuffs.
Ooh, how? How do you do that?
I've done that.
While the officers were talking
to
them.
Yes, I have done that.
You slipped out of the handcuffs?
Yes, I got put in back of a cop car with the handcuffs on, but my wrists were so skinny, I could just slide them off. I remember.
They probably didn't think you were a threat.
We have to stop here right now. I know that you've been – I didn't know you'd actually been handcuffed.
I have a witness who saw me take them off, so I'm okay.
You got out – you slipped out of the handcuffs?
Yeah, I put them back on. Well, when they pull me back out.
Man, you were a bad kid.
Yeah.
I don't know. When I got handcuffed, they did not – I got skinny wrists, and it hurt.
Oh, didn't you get your arms and feet handcuffed, Ben?
Weren't
you
on the full-on –
I think you did the full-on thing, right? Tased?
Actually, you know what? When I was transferred to a different state, yes.
Oh, my gosh.
I was in handcuffs, feet cuffs with chains, but so was everybody else.
That must have been the most depressing moment of your life. You must have been like –
Is that it like... was, but I knew that mom and dad were picking me up in like 2 hours with food. So I was like,
I don't care what you're doing to me. Like in Wrongfully Accused, in the movie where he gets on the bus.
No, I got in a van. And we went to like four different states first. I love that our listeners have no idea what's going on.
They drove you around from state to state until you got
I just had to go from Nevada to Utah, but we went to California and Washington, Oregon, picking up other random little people that needed to go to different places.
Random prisoners.
Let me tell you, for the drivers, $2, though, you can find out why.
The drivers did buy us so. Little Caesars.
Yeah, they were probably like, chill, cool, guys. You guys want some pizza? I mean, I would make friends. I'd be like, what's up? You're regular people. Let's talk.
Okay. Well, so.
Anyways. Here we go.
Okay, so this guy slipped out of handcuffs and ran and jumped over the.
off the inner freeway? What did he do?
While officers were talking to the man, he slipped out of handcuffs and took off running. He jumped over the Desert Inn Arterial, I guess is what it's called, and was immediately struck by a vehicle headed on the road.
Yeah. Oh, so it's like a road, a freeway?
Yeah, arterial feeds into the freeway.
So
yeah.
He hit someone, ran, got caught by police, got out of handcuffs, got hit.
Immediately gets hit by a car.
You know, what would have been nice is if he got hit and that by person drove off.
Okay. Yeah, keep it going.
Wow.
Pay it forward.
Karma. Pay it forward. The police chase that guy, put him in handcuffs, he gets out. Props to anybody who can slip out of handcuffs. Jeez, I always feel like that's a superpower, but apparently now, it's more common
it's
than
probably normal. The cops didn't do a good job of tightening them.
Well, but anyways, he was hospitalized in serious condition, and then he died.
He didn't make it.